everybody, Megan Campbell here, and today we're going to focus on doing an energizing practice and a short 10-minute sequence that's based on my TV show, Megan Campbell's Yoga for Women. And this practice is a really good one to do first thing in the morning when you're getting up, before you embark on your day, or perhaps if you're feeling a little bit of mild depression, because we're working with heart openers and shoulder openers, chest openers. So, as most of you know, when we're feeling most alive and vibrant is when this area of our body is nice and open. So it allows us to feel connected with our community as well as we come into our day with our families and our jobs and such and all the other different roles that we play. Before we get started, I suggest that you go ahead and grab yourself some yoga props if you have them, like a bolster or block and a strap. And if not, ties work well, or towels, same as books. And just have them handy in case you need them throughout the practice. So we're gonna get started on all fours, coming onto your hands and knees. So your wrists are underneath your shoulders and your knees are underneath your hips. You're gonna inhale to lift your tail and chest and perhaps the gaze and the chin very gently. And exhale to tuck the tail, chin to chest as you draw your navel in towards the spine. So you inhale into cow pose, rolling the shoulders back. And exhale into cat pose as you press down into your hands. You'll do a few more rounds, inhaling to open the front line of the body and exhaling to open the back line. A nice long deep breath, inviting the breath through the nose, allowing the jaw and the tongue to stay relaxed. If you are comfortable with these movements, feel free to do them with the eyes closed to change your experience or your relationship to them. So last two rounds. And next time you inhale, come into a neutral spine. Curl your toes under, and as you exhale, lift your hips and melt your heart towards your thighs, so your head just softly hangs between the biceps. Just making sure if your knees need to be bent to lengthen your back, that that's okay, and that there's no stress or strain in your hips or in your shoulders. So pressing the ground away with your hands and feeling yourself lift up and out. So keeping your left heel pressing down, you're going to inhale your right leg up towards the sky through internal rotation. And exhale your knee to your navel. Look forward and step your foot up between your hands, lowering your left knee to the earth, and you can fold the left side of the mat or place the pillow underneath your knee for extra cushioning. If this feels like enough for you today, feel free to stay here and continue to draw your heart forward through the gate of the shoulders. If you're feeling ready, you can climb up onto your right thigh, and making sure your tail is heavy, lower abdominals are lifting so you're not sinking into your low back. You're then gonna take a hold of your strap, or your towel, whatever you have handy. Nice wide grip. We're going to bring it down to the front of the front leg. And you're going to inhale your arms up above your head. And you're going to exhale to roll them back behind you. So very simple. Inhale, shoulder flossing. And exhale down in front of you. So every time you inhale, taking the arms up. If your elbows are bending, take your grip wider. And every time you exhale, they come down. So two more. Inhaling. Feeling the lift from the root. Exhale to soften into the hips a little bit. Last one, inhale. And exhale. Then we inhale to come back up. And exhale, lower the hands down in front of you. Place your strap to the side. Curl the back toes under so your leg is straight. And sweep your right arm up your right leg and towards the sky to twist the chest open. If your wrist is sore, you can lift onto fingertips. And softening through the hips, you want to keep drawing your right hip back, and you look where it's comfortable, so up to the side or down. And the next exhale, we'll melt that right hand back to the ground and step back into downward dog. With your feet together, same thing on the other side. So you inhale your left leg up to the sky, and you exhale your knee to your navel, coming forward, lower the right knee to the earth. So patting the mat if you need to, keeping the hands down or crawling up. Grab a hold of the strap and same thing on this side, shoulder flossing. So we inhale, arms rise. And exhale to lower behind us. Inhale, lifting from the root, lengthening. And exhale, softening. Again, inhaling. And exhaling. Opening through the chest and shoulders. Last round, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. This time we inhale the arms up. And exhale, softly melt down. Placing the strap to the side. Curl the back toes under. Leg goes straight. And we inhale the left arm to the sky. And trying to roll open gently, belly pressing against thighs. So we start to awaken abdominal organs with that deep belly breath. And then exhale, melt your left hand down to the ground and step back into downward dog. This time you're going to inhale your right leg to the sky. And once again, exhale, knee to navel, step your foot up between your hands and we lower the heel instead of the knee. So your toes are pointing at about 45 degrees. And you inhale to rise up into warrior one. And as you exhale, bend your front knee and press into the outside edge of your back foot. Finding stability on your feet. From here, interlace the fingers, press the palms to the sky, lengthen through the sides of the waist and draw your shoulder blades down the spine. Lifting through the collarbone, maybe looking up. And then next exhale, look forward, sweep your hands behind your back, interlace your fingers. Keep the palms facing one another, inhale your shoulder blades together, and exhale, dive to the inside of your right thigh and start to bring your hands past your head towards the floor. Keep drawing your right hip back. Deep breaths giving you power here. And then from the core, rise back up, release the hands, inhale. And exhale, float your hands down and step your right foot back into downward dog. Inhale your left leg to the sky. Exhale your knee to your navel, step it up softly and lower the back heel. Find the feet and then inhale, rise when you feel steady. And exhale to stabilize. Gently drawing the left femur back into the socket so your right hip is rolling forward. Interlace your fingers in a non-habit way. So the other baby finger is in front and press the palms to the sky. And draw up from the lower belly so you have stability through the legs and the root. Maybe look up to lengthen and open through the chest. Forward, exhale, float your hands behind your back. Inhale, lift and open the heart. And exhale to melt down to the inner thigh. If you can get there, diving through. Drawing your left hip back, hands away from your head. And from the root, inhale, rise up, reach back up to the sky. And exhale, hands come down, stepping back into downward dog. On your next inhale, you're going to pull yourself forward into a high push-up. Through chaturanga, exhale, bend the elbows back and come down to softly land on the mat. Point the toes, slide your hands back by your hips, and lift the entire back of the body to the sky for a nice, energizing, powerful locus pose. Lifting up as high as you need. If you need the support of your feet, they can come back down. And then we exhale, lower to the ground. And with the help of your hands, just flip your body over onto your back. Bending into the knees, place the feet on the earth. And your hands by your hips. Now we're going to stretch open the front line a little bit more, so pressing down through the low back so you feel the pubic bone lift. Start to inhale your hips up off the ground and walk the shoulder blades together underneath you, perhaps interlacing fingers again for, say, Tubandasana bridge pose. Pressing the tail away from the back of the heart. Feel length in the spine. And then melt your hips back down, releasing hands if you need to. Without lifting the head and chest off the ground, just gently draw the knees in towards the chest. Nice soothing pose. Take a couple of long, deep breaths. And you have options for the next part. You can either do bridge again. You can do flowing bridge, which would look like inhaling and taking the arms back to open the shoulders as you lift your hips, and exhaling to lower your hips and your hands back down, working with coordination. Or if wheel is part of your practice, your hands will come by your shoulders for one round. So bridge, flowing bridge, or wheel pose. And when you're ready, low back presses down, hips lift, and you inhale onto the head, keeping your elbows squeezing in, and perhaps exhale to lift your head off the ground. Any pressure in the shoulders, you come back down and work with bridge until you feel open enough to rise up. And we'll exhale, tuck chin to chest. And if you're in wheel, and lower back down. This time, bring your knees together, feet wide, turn the palms to face the sky. Into constructive rest pose. Close the eyes, feel the shesha, or the residue of the pose on your body, the heart beating, circulation, blood moving, that energy coming from within. Together, draw your right knee in towards your chest. Lengthen your left leg straight on the mat. Bring the forehead up to the knee, lifting from the chest, little contraction for the spines. And exhale to lower head and shoulders down. Reach your right arm out to the right, palm down. Inhale fully to fill up. And exhale to twist over to your left. And your knee can rest on a block if it doesn't come down to the ground. Or the books if you're using those instead. Deep belly breaths. And we inhale the right knee to come back up. And we exhale to switch sides, hugging your left knee in. Lifting from the heart, come up to contract the spine. And then gently release down. Take your left arm out to the left, inhale fully, and exhale, emptying out. Just wringing out any last bit of tension, stress or strain before you start your day, so the body and mind are both open. Breath, so if you feel called, you can place your feet back down
And it's important that you stay as long as you can to get the full benefits. And you can remove the block and spread out and take as long as you can in Shavasana. So constructive rest again. Knowing that even when you're resting, your body is hard at work. And after a couple of minutes in Shavasana, you want to come up and dedicate your practice either through a prayer, making a wish, or taking just a few more moments to simply enjoy your breath.
Namaste. Have a great day.